flat on your back. Lie flat on your back. And take your feet to the bottom corners of your mat, maybe even a little bit wider. Your hands, one hand on your belly, one hand on your chest. All right. And we do this so when we start to evoke the parasympathetic nervous system, we can feel the belly rising and falling, and it gives us just another touch point with our breath work. We can't be afraid of change. You may feel very secure in the pond that you're in, but if you never venture out of it, you never know there's a thing such as an ocean or a sea. And so if you're uncomfortable with yoga, I get it. He is. But everything we're doing here is useful. The breath work, the poses, the forms. And you just start to let your natural rhythm of your breath take over. There's no hurry to try to get anywhere too fast. Breathing in through the nose, filling up the belly, the ribs, your chest. Exhale through the mouth, let it go. Again, deep breath in through the nose. You're filling up your belly, your ribs, your chest. Open your mouth. Beautiful. One more time. Breathe it in. Ribs move east to west, and then let it go. Start to wiggle your fingers and wiggle your toes. Reach your arms back, your feet towards the front of the house. This is a full body stretch. You can put your legs together now. And you're maybe even arching your back a little bit so the small of your back comes up off the earth. Now set your back down, pull your knees into your chest, engage your belly. Beautiful. And we'll find happy baby, so your hands grab the outside of your feet. Pull up those shorts if you need to. All right. And we're just driving those knees towards the earth. We're just driving the knees towards the earth. Grab your feet. And you can get playful and silly here. You can just rock left to right. All right. Bring your knees into your chest. Let your feet go and rock right. Pause a moment for gratitude. Three things that you're thankful for, babe. Me. What else?
Say that loud.
Yeah. Well, you can say it to yourself.
Golf and the kids.
Awesome. All right. Push into the earth. Let's come up. So Kyle is a golfer. He also lifts weights. And he runs. So he has the tightest shoulders that I've seen. Let's come all the way seated. You can sit on your knees, on your heels, or you can sit crisscross, whatever feels good to you. And we'll start with a shoulder opener today. So if you have a robe or a yoga strap, you can even use a belt. You can use a kitchen towel or beach towel. It's got to be about, how long is that? 3 feet?
4 feet
long, and it needs to be taut. So when it's up over your head, it should make it like this giant V, and the material's pretty taut. So I'm gonna give this to you, and we'll start down low. Start down low. All right, on your inhale, bring it all the way up to your degree of flexibility, but you're lifted. On your exhale, let's take it down. Start to breathe with it. Inhale, come up. Beautiful. Exhale, come down. Spine is nice and straight this time. Breathe in, come up. Exhale, take it down. This time we'll hold it at the top. Inhale, come up. Exhale, come down. Beautiful. This time we'll see if we can rotate, keep rotating all the way back. Inhale, come up. Exhale, rotate back towards me. Your arms can bend, that's okay. And breathe with that, sit with that, stretch the uncomfortable. Is this uncomfortable for you?
Yep,
that's okay. And we're finding some external rotation here. Some range of motion. Is your shoulder a ball and socket joint?
Yes.
Yes, in the ball and socket joint. Inhale, come up. And then exhale, rotate forward. We'll do that again like 5 more times. Inhale up and using your breath, exhale, swing it back. Inhale, come up. And then exhale forward. So let's take that 4 more times with your own breath. Breathe in. And breathe out. Beautiful. Last 3, 2, make sure your spine is straight, your neck is a natural extension, and last one, breathe in and up, breathe it out and down. All right, let go of your strap, and we'll take child's pose. So for some of us, child's pose comes pretty easy. For people with tight hips and shoulders, it's not so easy. So for that reason, I'll stick this right, lift your head, right there, and you can rest your chest on your pillow.
If you have a bolster at home, awesome. If you don't, use a pillow or roll up a blanket. Your big toes are touching, your knees are pretty wide here. And as your hips sink back, your forehead and your chest sinks forward. Breathe in. Exhale, soften. Take two more breaths here. Beautiful, and last one. All right, so keep your eyes open. Let's meet in quadruped, that's box pose. Stack your joints. Remove your block or your blanket if you took it. Inhale, open up to cow. So your chest and your heart will lift and your belly will drop. Exhale, navel to spine, tuck the chin, tuck the pelvis. We're looking for a cervical spine stretch here. Space between the scapula. Inhale, open to cow. Beautiful. Exhale, tuck the chin, tuck the pelvis, cat. One more time, inhale, open. And exhale, contract and close. Nice. Neutral spine, neutral neck. Extend your left arm in front of you. And your right foot back. Beautiful. We'll switch sides. Feel the belly lift through the navel. Beautiful. And hand and foot down. Curl under your toes, downward facing dog. I know you don't like to be here for too long, so we won't be. Let's walk our feet to our hands. And slowly roll all the way up. How are we doing? All right, inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold, lead with your chest. All the way down, all the way down. Can we touch our toes today? So if we can't touch our toes, we bend our knees. Let's walk it to the front of the mat. Stay in that forward fold. Sorry, I just wanted to get you more in the picture. So forward fold at the top of your mat. I'll do it with you. All right. Separate your feet about hip width distance. Take your right hand in between your feet. Inhale. Left arm up, and we'll use a block here if you can't quite reach the ground. Or two blocks. One block, good? All right, and we're twisting and we're opening. Every inhale, you're using that direction breath, breathe in. On your exhale, like you're wringing out a washcloth, find some space to twist. Beautiful. And you can bend a knee, you can pop a hip here. Breathe in. On your exhale, take your left hand down and we'll switch sides. On the inhale is when, are you good?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Take breaks when you need to. So left hand down. Inhale, take this arm up. And prepare for the twist. On the inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist and rotate. Beautiful. You can lean into me if you need to. Take three more breaths here. And last breath, big breath in. Exhale, close. Take the right hand down. All right. We'll bend the knees. Bend the knees and slowly roll up. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, open arm twist to the right. Keep your arms at about a T. Keep breathing. Beautiful. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, open arm twist to the left. Inhale up. Goalpost your arms. Goalpost. There we go. Look up. And just sit with this shape. Micro bend your knees. Beautiful. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, fold. All the way down. Halfway lift. Plant your hands. Plant your hands, walk your feet to the back, drop your knees, drop your knees. All right, how are we feeling?
Fine.
All right, take your hips back to your heels, child's pose. So from child's pose, we won't use the prop this time. Take your right arm underneath your left elbow. There you go. So this is called threading the needle, and keep, if you can, take your shoulder to the earth. If you can't, we can use a block. Just to make the ground a little bit closer to you. And this left arm can extend up over your head, or you can take it and tuck it back into the right thigh. All right. Does that feel good?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. All right. If you need a little bit more, extend this left leg out beside you. If you don't need more, leave your knee where it's at. Two more breaths here. Unraveling back to child's pose. We'll take it on the opposite side, so the left arm will weave underneath the body. That left shoulder can be on a block if it needs a little bit more support. And we take three deep diaphragmatic breaths here, starting at the base of the belly, moving all the way up, and then riding that wave back down to the tailbone. Beautiful. Let's come out of this. Curl under your toes. We'll take it to down dog. And from our inverted V shape, so you see, there you go, you fixed your palms. Step the right foot in between the hands, crescent lunge. So crescent lunge, high up on the ball of the back foot. You could also take crescent lunge on the back knee. So let's take it, and the top of the foot would be down. All right, so keep walking this right foot up a little bit so you can get some leverage here. So your hands can be at your thigh bone, your hands can be at your hips, your heart, or up in the sky. You choose. Inhale, lengthen. Take your arms up. Exhale, take that big open arm twist towards me. Feel it? Good. Inhale, flip the front palm, reach up and back. So we're reaching up and back. And then on your exhale, let's windmill down, straddle this foot for runner stretch. Or for lizard, if that feels better for you. So the difference between lizard and runner stretch is the placement of your hands. So if you want runners, take to the outside of the knee. Beautiful. And walk your heel a little bit forward so your toes aren't. There you go. Is this feeling good?
Mm-hmm.
One more big breath in. On your exhale, straighten this leg, sit your hips back. All right, back to child's pose. Curl under your toes, downward facing dog. Step the left foot through between the hands, and we'll drop the back knee for crescent lunge. Drop the back knee, top of the foot in, crescent lunge. All right. You look a little angry. Arms up. Exhale, big open arm twist to the left. Allow for any wobble. Flip the front palm, reach up and back. Cramp?
Yeah.
Okay. And then we'll straddle the front foot. Yeah? Put your head down. Shoulders down and back. Is this very uncomfortable for you?
In my calves.
In your calves. Bend your knees. There you go. Is that better?
Mm-hmm.
Shoulders down. Chest as close to your thighs as you can get it. Okay. Do you feel a difference?
A little bit.
Kind of? Okay. All right. Let's slowly start to walk our feet to our hands. Pull your left knee into the chest. Give it a squeeze. And I am here to be your wall if you need some. There you go. All right. Keep your right hand where it is. Open up with your left.
It's hard.
It's really hard. Use a wall if you need a wall. So what we're doing is we're lifting up that right knee, and then we're looking over our left shoulder. Switch sides.
What's the trick? Put your tongue on your balance. You put your tongue on the roof of your mouth.
No, you find a spot in the room that's not going to move, and you concentrate like your energy there. So that's just a focus point. If you wanted more one point of focus, and your breath. We try to make our breath as fluid as we can. The moment you change your gaze, your balance will be compromised. So just notice. Beautiful. Let's take both feet down. Inhale, arms up, look up. Exhale, take your hands to your heart. We'll take that two more times. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, heart. Close your eyes. Last one. Inhale up. Exhale, hands to heart. Lift your eyes open. From this hands to your heart posture, take it up to funnel mudra. And you're envisioning all this goodness and light to funnel right into your heart space. Breathe in. All those gratitudes on your exhale, hands meet in high prayer. They come to your heart. And we'll take it to the mat for spinal articulation before we leave today. So flat on your mat, on your back. Pull your knees into your chest. All right. And we'll take a figure four cross. So this ankle, your left ankle on top of your right knee. It's like a modified pigeon pose, a supine pigeon. And this left foot can be on the mat if that feels good. It could be up by you if that feels better. All right, take a deep breath in, like a long, deep breath. Kids, right there. Breathe in. Exhale, twist to the right.
Sound like the garage door was opening.
Breathe in. Exhale, big twist over here. You can tee out your arms. Hey, your foot made it to the ground. All right. And we want to try to keep both scapulas on the earth. Breathe. Breathe. Coming back to center, we'll uncross our feet and pull this left knee up into the chest again. You can find an extension here. You can stay with it bent. Beautiful. We'll catch the foot and we'll rock the baby. So you're just pretending that this part of your leg is like a little baby. You're just gonna rock it side to side. And you're breathing, and it's fluid. And if you've lost track of the breath, that's okay. Just bring it back. All right, and then we'll find stillness, switch feet. So this right ankle will cross on top of the left knee. And you can stay here with it rooted, or you can bring it all up, up to you. Take a deep breath in through the nose, elongate your spine, exhale your feet to drop to the left. And your arms, you choose, they can tee out, they can be at your belly. When I did this yesterday, I saw an owl fly over our house. These breaths are deep and big. They start at the base of your belly, like you're filling up a balloon. They fill up your belly, your ribs, your chest. And then on your exhale, release. What, Winnie?
Please help me put my pants on.
Okay. Take three more deep belly breaths here.
She was having trouble.
Okay. We're almost done. Can you not play in the playroom for like 2 more minutes?
Oh, yeah. Sure. Can we watch our shows?
Inhale, come back to center.
Why not? Mommy said we can watch.
And then pull the left knee into the chest. Give it a squeeze. You can extend this left leg. And you're breathing. And then we'll take this left knee kind of outside to the diagonal and bring the foot up towards your chest. Huh? Right knee, excuse me. And rock the baby. Right, slowly release this. We'll take both knees into the chest. Find blissful baby again. And just notice what happens in 20 minutes to the hips. Bend your knees. Catch your feet. Find happy baby. And you see you're a little bit looser. A little bit more playful. Beautiful. All right, let's take our feet up. Arms tee out. This is rejuvenation pose. This is waterfall. So you're getting blood all to these lower extremities. Flush. Fresh blood. And we'll bring the feet all the way down. One hand belly, one hand chest. We'll take 5 deep breaths here to end our practice. Letting go of anything that doesn't serve you on the exhalation. Knowing that however you shut up today is perfect and exactly where you need to be. Pull your knees into your chest. Flicker your eyes open. Give yourself a big hug. Thank you for showing up today. We'll roll to the right. Check back in with those 3 gratitudes that you started with from the beginning of your practice. Take it with you. Weave it throughout your day. And then push into the earth. Come to Sukhasana. That's easy sit pose. And we'll face each other. Sukhasana. And we'll sit up really straight, and we can hold hands since we're together. If you have somebody that you love at your house, you can hold their hand, whether it's a spouse or a kid. And we'll breathe deep, 3 breaths. Flicker your eyes open. Hands find your heart space. All my love, all my blessings, and all of my